What's up guys, BIOBEAN here. So in the video when we were talking about telomeres, I said that there is a little bit more to the story. So now I'm gonna get into what that story is. So let's get started. So when we look at a chromosome, we can see that all chromosomes contain telomeres. So telomeres are the long repeats of unnecessary DNA that exists at the end of all chromosomes to avoid shortening needed DNA during DNA replication. If this is a little bit confusing to you, then please go to my previous video where I talked about telomeres and telomerase. So in that video, I talked about how telomeres shorten over time in humans because we do not possess telomerase. So what happens as a result of this telomere shortening? So because humans do not possess telomerase, every time that we do a round of replication on the lagging strand, we get a shortening of the telomeres. So what happens as we progressively shorten the telomere? So here we can see this is kind of like a little piece of our chromosome and the end of the chromosome containing the telomere. So you can see after successive rounds of replication, you get a shorter and shorter telomere that happens. And so because these telomeres continue to shorten and shorten, there reaches a point where it's so short that the cell goes, all right, stop, hold on. You guys are about to start cutting into the needed DNA. So it tells those cells that are reaching the point where they are shortening their telomeres to the point there will be no telomere, it tells that cell, stop replicating. So that is called cell senescence. So cell senescence is when replication stops within a cell that has reached a certain amount of telomere shortening. So once we get to about this stage where we're about to have no telomere left, the cell will enter into senescence and it will no longer enter into the cell cycle and it will no longer undergo replication. Because if it were to continue to do replication, we would start eating into our needed DNA and then our cells would just start going haywire. And so to prevent that haywire, which may lead to cancer or other diseases, it tells the cell to stop before it is starting to cut into the needed DNA. And so we've actually calculated how many times a cell can undergo replication before it reaches senescence. This is what we call the Hayflick limit. So the Hayflick limit, which is named after the guy Hayflick, who was the one who discovered how many replications can occur before senescence happens. So this Hayflick limit is about 60 to 70 times. So we have found that a cell can only undergo replication between 60 and 70 times before it reaches senescence. So that is the average Hayflick limit for a cell, is about 60 to 70 rounds of replication. And it reaches this limit because it has now reached the point where it has almost no telomere left and is therefore going to cut into needed DNA. Because cells possess this Hayflick limit and then enter into senescence, this is what we believe contributes to old age. So when you die of old age, we believe that really that means that a lot of your cells have entered into senescence and are therefore unable to continue to keep up with the demands of everyday life, because if they get injured, then they are going to undergo apoptosis and there's going to be no cell there to replace it. So we believe that this Hayflick limit and the shortening of telomeres is what is contributing to old age. So that concludes our video talking about telomere shortening, how that contributes to the Hayflick limit and cell senescence. If this or any other concept related to biology is something you're confused about, then please visit biologybean.com where you can access all of your tutoring needs. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.